Hi, this is Shop Talk, and I'm Ria Tanwat Cotrillo. We bring you the second installment of our Guide to 2012 series. Now, after travel, we'll talk about food, particularly the must-visit restaurants this year. And we have the authority on the subject who will give us her suggestions. I'm talking about Nana Ozaeta. She is the editor-in-chief of Food Magazine. Hello, Nana, and thanks for coming on Shop Talk.
Thank you also for having me.
Okay, as if we all haven't had it eaten enough during the holiday season, we're going to talk about food again and the food that we really must try for 2012. What are the concepts that you think are really going to fly this year?
Well, you know, I mean, I think the way to look at what's going on this year is to look a little bit about what's going on, what's been hot or going up last year. Yeah, I'm getting my years confused now, no? And one thing I noticed was the Asian invasion. Whereas in the 1990s and early 2000s, we got a lot of U.S. chains coming to our shores. Now we're getting concepts, chains, brands from nearer our shores. You know, you've got Bulgogi Brothers coming from Korea, Bonchon, which has been expanding a lot,
right.
Cha Time from Taiwan. There's also Shabuwei from Japan. So these are popular brands from our Asian neighbors that are now coming in. And as Filipinos, we seem to enjoy Asian food. There's so much variety. It's a little different from our food, but not too exotic, and
right.
It's
and
very
family
oriented.
And the taste is really what Pinoy's like.
Yeah,
you know,
full of flavor.
Yeah, yes.
Right. So I see that going on. I think one thing that will be really hot this year are ramen noodle shops. And we're not talking instant ramen here, and what you buy in the supermarket. We're talking authentic ramen noodles, and chefs, both Japanese and Filipinos, are experimenting with flavors. And that's like comfort food for us, but it's really tasty. And I think we will see a lot more of those this year.
I don't think people realize how much work goes into like a real ramen, because I was talking to some chefs before, and to make the real Japanese ramen, you have to train for like a year or something like that in Japan, because it's a whole different art and skill on its own.
Yeah, actually, from what I've read, in Japan, it's almost like a religion. There are ramen chefs, so that's all they do, and that's all they train for, and they train for years and years and years to get that, you know, that springy, tasty noodle, and then that broth, even just creating that really super special broth is another secret that and it's really great that we don't have to go to Japan to experience it. Now, I'm not going to say that the ramen that we have here is exactly like what they have in Japan, but I mean, people are really coming up with wonderful
it
with
is
wonderful
very
yes.
good and for me
and
like,
healthy
if I'm looking for a Japanese restaurant to go to, I look who's inside, and if I see, you know, Japanese people there, businessmen or families, that's a place to go, because
yes.
you know, if it's good enough for
yes.
them, then it must be pretty authentic. Okay, another trend that we used to see a lot, like in the early 2000s, was fusion this and fusion that. That's not so hot anymore, right?
Not so. It hasn't been in for quite a while. I think now we're going for authentic cuisines. One other trend is Tex-Mex and Mexican food. In the last couple of months, I've noticed so many concepts springing up in Makati, in Quezon City, in San Juan, all over. And I think Filipinos, you know, a few years back, we didn't really know what Tex-Mex was, except for a taco here, a burrito there. And now I think, especially young people, are saying it's becoming part of your daily, oh, let's go have a burrito, or let's go have a quesadilla.
Right. And again, it's becoming more authentic with
yes.
the different concepts.
Yeah, it's authentic.
Right.
They're slow cooking their pork. Mm-hmm. They're making tortillas from scratch, making their own hot sauces or chili sauces. So it's really fun to discover.
Right, right. What about when it comes to desserts? I think cupcakes have had their run. So what can we look forward to?
Well, I think now it's sort of an explosion. In the last few months, so many sweet shops have opened in Makati, in Quezon City, all over. And now I can't really say that it's going to be cupcakes or it's going to be, last year it was like macaron, French macarons. I'm not yet sure what it is now. It might be bars or it might be cookies, sort of going back to the old to what we what we grew up with. So I think I see that coming back. You've got a lot of pastry shops opening. Park Avenue Desserts in Magallanes, Sinfully by Shangri-La, which opened an outlet in Greenbelt.
Yes, I've been there.
Yeah, Kitchen's nice. Best Patisserie moved to the Fort, and now they got a wonderful space there. Karen's Kitchen, which has been a home baker for so many years, she finally opened in the Petron station on, along EDSA in
right.
Right,
outside Yes, she's been on the show.
There you go, And Sweet Bella is in the Fort, and I heard that they'll be expanding to Alabang. So a lot of these home bakers are now moving into pastry chefs moving into retail, and are able to sell, you know, cakes, pastries, pies, chocolates, and are able to sustain that business. So it really proves that Filipinos are sweet tooths, and there's no going back.
Wonderful. Okay, going back to the restaurant, since we've already listed the dessert places we should check out. Of course, you mentioned the Korean places like Bulgogi Brothers and Chicken Bonchon and all that. What are the other Asian restaurants that we really should get ourselves to, you think?
Well, Shabu Wei is one. They just opened, if I'm not mistaken, they just opened their second branch in Rockwell Power Plant. And that's a great experience of, you know, cooking your food right in front of you.
Right.
And they've got
something
wonderful
ingredients.
Something
the kids always enjoy.
Yes. Yeah, so that's one place that people could definitely check out.
Bonifacio High Street is also set to open, like that new area where Jamba Juice is, right? I know a lot of that is going to be restaurants. What can we look forward to in that area?
Yeah, I'm not yet sure what's going to be out there, but it'll be the way Ayala likes to work is that they always like to come up, whenever they open a new mall, they always like to come up with new concepts. So you're not going to get the same old, and that's exciting. So, you know, I mean, I think there'll be a lot of new places there.
That's
to look
great.
Forward to.
All right. So for people who are already in the food business, what can they do, you think, to stay current, stay on trend, but at the same time stick to whatever their specialties are?
Yeah, well, it's really a challenge. I mean, the industry is so competitive. While there's so many restaurants opening, there are also sadly a number closing as well. I mean, that's the nature of the business. What I can, you know, from having covered the food industry for about almost 10 years now, you know, the rules are still the same. First of all, be distinctive. You don't have to try and copy everybody. You don't have to try and be everything. You don't have to try and please everyone. You know, you come up with a few signature dishes or a few standout dishes that you're known for, and people will come, whether it's your fried chicken, whether it's your barbecue. Really make that a standout dish, and people will come from far and wide to sample that.
Right. So do you think the sort of artisanal trend is going to continue? You have your artisanal ice creams, you have your all those little entrepreneurs who are doing really well, you know, like in the weekend food markets. Is that something we're going to see?
Oh, definitely. I think it's a great testing ground, because when you say artisanal, that means doing something with a lot of love. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that it's really good. Okay, sometimes there's a misconception. So it's great to have them at weekend markets, and there they can actually test their products, because, you know, you make your own homemade ice cream, fine, it's wonderful, everything's all natural, but you can't get the consistency. You know, you change your milk or whatever, and then it's not as good anymore.
Right.
So that's the other side of artisanal foods. They're wonderful, and every time I go to weekend markets, I always try and pick up something new.
Right.
But the challenge there is for these young entrepreneurs to just make sure it's consistent, make sure their product is really good. Even if they put a lot of love and a lot of wonderful ingredients into it, if they don't get it as consistent as more commercial products, then it's a little hard for them to at least maintain.
That's true.
Yeah.
Another trend, of course, is like the healthy organic produce. Where do we see that going in 2012?
Well, you know, a few years back, we were starting to see these organic markets sprout out, and they would only be here for weekends. You know, you'd have to go on a Saturday or on a Sunday. And for me, it was always my problem, because I don't usually go out early in the morning on a Saturday to go to the market. And so I was always looking for a place where that would have all these products.
Right.
products every day, 7 days a week.
Exactly.
And this year we're happy to have, for example, Eco Market just opened a few weeks or a few months ago. Eco Market is the part of the Eco Store group, and they just opened in Serenda, and you can go any time of the day or any time of the week to get your organic produce, your organic coffee, or your whatever natural products you're looking for. You don't
Fantastic.
Have to wait for a Saturday or a Sunday to do that.
Right.
Another place is Sugarleaf, which opened last year in Wilson Street in San Juan, and now Sugarleaf has another branch in Makati. So
oh,
they're
really?
Also expanding, and they also have organic products. They have superfoods, I mean, really, really healthy stuff. If you're into raw food, you can go there and get all the food you need for your salads.
Yeah.
So it's becoming more and more accessible, and even if for us who want to eat healthier, sometimes it's difficult to go out and look for that food, and I think this coming year there'll be more places for us to
right.
for us to access that.
Yeah, to have it more accessible, I think is a key. I mean, everybody wants to eat healthier
yes.
and be healthier, but they also want it to be convenient.
Yeah. And not right. to mention the supermarkets are really playing their part, whether it's the SM Group or Robinson's or Shopwise, Rustan's. I mean, they're bringing in every time I go to the supermarket, they're like new items, some of them high-end, some of them inexpensive, but quite healthy, from all over the world, and so the choice is really there.
Right.
So it's us who has to, go and pick up those healthy products.
Right, I think when the demand is there, you know, those products will become more available to us. What about a lot of locally made dairy products? I know, you know, these dairies are sprouting out in Rizal and Laguna. Is that going to grow as well?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I'm quite astounded at the way our dairy industry is picking up, starting with fresh milk. You know, most of the milk that we get here is imported from abroad, but now in the supermarket shelves you can get local milk products and local yogurt products as well, not to mention quesong puti and even mozzarella, local mozzarella,
right.
Local goat's cheese, and it's becoming a bit of a, there's still a long way to go. Because Filipinos, we don't eat goat cheese every day, but
right.
but I think with the availability, I think it's something that we're going to see a lot more of. And what's interesting is that before you could just see the local fresh milk at your weekend markets. Now you're seeing them at the
supermarkets.
That has always been the problem of the industry. There aren't enough cows here to give us all our milk. But thanks to these farmers who are investing in their production, they can now, some of them can now really supply supermarkets, which
yeah.
requires a lot more cows to give us milk.
For us consumers, though. All right. Well, we're going to give you more food trends and advice to foodpreneurs after this short break. Stay tuned. Shop Talk will be right back.